Hi guys, you are watching channel Mr. Electron. This what you see is a BLDC motor from an old Xerox photocopy machine, and this is a 10mm pulley, but it is not fitting the shaft of the BLDC motor, so I'm using this rubber sleeve to place it firmly inside like this. As you can see that the pulley is perfectly placed, but it is still a little wobbly. So let's place this screw here to make it more stable. Yeah, and now it should perform perfectly nice. And guys, I got this drill press from Banggood's, link is in the description. So guys, your question for today is, can a 10 watts DC motor generate enough electricity to start a 1000 watts DC motor? As you can see that I'm using L brackets for making a base stand for this motor, and I got these brackets also from Banggood's, and link for these will also be provided in the description. You can check them out. Okay, and this cordless drill is also from Banggood's. It works really nice. You can see that the stand is perfectly made. Now I'm going to test it at super high speed with the help of this BLDC motor controller, link for which will be provided in the description. As you saw that the speed in the motoring mode was super high, let's test it as a generator now. Here I am using a car indicator bulb, and as you can see that it is glowing really bright. Now let's turn off the lights and test it again, and yeah, it is bright enough. Now let's place it on the bicycle generator stand. I have this aluminum base stand on which I am going to place this BLDC motor, which I am going to use as a three-phase electric generator AC with a power generation capability of 240 watts, which is 24 volts and 10 amperes AC. Now to convert that three-phase AC into DC, I am going to use this three-phase rectifier. Let's measure its generated voltage, pointing the meter towards 200 volts DC mode. As you saw that the maximum generated voltage was 19 volts, let's measure the current now. The current was only 3.64 amps because the friction between belt and pulley is very less. So we will have to increase that friction with the help of this bearings setup that I'm making now. Here what I'm going to do is connect the two bearings in series with each other without anything in between, and this bearing setup is going to press the belt more and more towards the surface of the pulley, thereby increasing the contact area of the belt to the surface of the pulley and thus increasing the friction between the belt and the pulley. This method is going to prevent the pulley from slipping when it is loaded heavily. This idea is going to serve three amazing advantages. The first is, it is going to increase the friction between the pulley and the belt. Second, it is going to increase the lifespan of the belt, which would slip against the pulley and wear off with time. And the third, we are only going to need one belt instead of the two and we will get double power out of it. As you can see that the setup is working smooth and the rectifier has also been placed on the base stand. Now I have connected a 250 watts bulb load to it for testing. Let's see how it performs. Now I'm going to add an additional bearing to the two bearing set to force the belt to stay in one place instead of sliding off the pulley. You can see that I have placed few washers in between the two bearings to create a pulley-like shape and the belt is placed in between. And now it works really well. Now guys, let's measure the generated amperes with the help of this MUST tool clamp meter, link for which has been provided in the description. The generated current, as you saw, was somewhere around 6.02 amperes and it also depends on the load. Higher the load, more is the current. Guys, this is another product that I got from Banggood's and this is a multimeter or a energy meter. Okay, let's open it. It works on DC only and it can display voltage, current, power and energy. And it also has the saving memory. The circuit diagram has been drawn and the maximum voltage rating range is 5 volts to 100 volts and current from 0 to 100 amperes with a heavy shunt resistance and precise display. So guys, as you can see that the bicycle generator project of mine is fully complete now. To the rectifier output terminals, I have connected this shunt resistance which is feeding signal to this meter of mine, okay. And this meter is going to display the generated voltage, current as well as energy. And I have used the simple telephone wire cables that contains 4 wires which are needed to be connected. Here, you see 4 wires. They work perfectly well. Also guys, I've changed the output wires. I was using red and blue one, now I'm using both of them as yellow. And I've connected 100 watts incandescent car headlamp bulb. Let's test it. As you saw on the display, the generated current was around 9 amperes and the power was up to 104 watts. Now I have connected a 35Ah battery, car battery, and it is very discharged, displaying only 6.29 volts. Let's run the generator and charge it. You can see as displayed that the charge on the battery has increased, although it is reducing because I ran the bicycle for a very little time and it was not enough to charge it fully, of course. It is showing 8.96 and decreasing. Also, I'm going to start a contest which is a great opportunity for you guys. To participate, you have to find the question hidden within the video and be the first one to answer it correctly. The first one to give the correct answer will have the following benefits. The first benefit is the opportunity to get his or her queries solved through direct discussion with me on Gmail, or they can also ask me to make a project of their choice.